During the first few months of World War I, SMS Emden wreaked havoc across the South Pacific and Indian Oceans. This sneaky light cruiser, led by Korvettenkapitän Karl von Muller, would use a fake smokestack to disguise herself as a British vessel. In a span of 3 months, SMS Emden managed to set over 30 Allied ships ablaze, and she eventually earned the nickname of the ocean's most dangerous vessel. The Swan of the East. SMS Emden, a Dresden-class light cruiser, was the pride and joy of the Imperial German Navy. The 3,650-ton Emden was fitted with 10 4.1-inch rapid-fire guns and could reach a top speed of 25 knots. Long, lean, and graceful, this lethal combination of firepower and speed made her the perfect commerce raider. The Swan of the East, as it was nicknamed by the Germans, was completed in 1909. She spent most of her overseas career in Tsingtao, a German leased Chinese territory, as part of the German East Asia Squadron. In 1913, the young SMS Emden received a new commander, Korvettenkapitän Karl von Muller. Born into a military family, Muller rose to his rank by impressing the German Navy's elite with his strategic abilities, including German Emperor Wilhelm II's brother. The 40-year-old Muller was cunning, astute, and strategic, all personality traits that would serve him well on Emden. World War I. In July of 1914, following the assassination of Archduke Franz Ferdinand of Austria, SMS Emden was the only German cruiser stationed in Tsingtao, as armored cruisers Scharmhorst and Gneisenau were in the South Pacific Ocean. The other German East Asia Squadron ship, SMS Leipzig, was en route to the coast of Mexico to replace a fallen vessel. Muller headed into open waters to prevent being captured in the predominantly British and Japanese-controlled waters where Emden was based. The ship would head towards a rallying point in the South Pacific, where the rest of the German Imperial Navy's East Asia Squadron ships would meet and then head to Germany together. On their way to the rendezvous, Muller managed to capture the Russian ship Ryazan. Emden's crew then disguised it as the German auxiliary cruiser Cormoran and sent it back to Tsingtao, marking the first vessel the German Navy captured in World War I. A clever plan. After the successful capture of the Soviet Ryazan, Emden's crew caught up with the rest of the German Imperial Navy's East Asia Squadron. Upon arrival, Muller had a proposal for the squadron's admiral. Instead of heading back to Germany, Emden would head west and raid Allied vessels, mainly British ones. Muller was sure that he and his crew could wreak havoc on the enemy's supply chains within a few months. The admiral was interested but hesitant, as light cruisers such as Emden lacked significant armor like larger ships. Still, the German vessel was more than a match for British destroyers and merchant ships, as Emden had torpedo tubes that could tackle heavier combatants if needed. There was also the risk of losing Emden, a relatively new, modern, and very valuable cruiser. But the possibility of a single German ship damaging the essential logistic chain of the British Navy was enough to convince the admiral. Soon, Muller was leading his 360-person crew into the Indian Ocean. But Emden needed an edge to survive. Although she was fast, the ship would still be vulnerable during the crucial seconds in which she closed in on a British vessel. Muller then had an idea, and it involved trickery. While on their own in hostile waters, he disguised the vessel as the equal-sized British cruiser HMS Yarmouth by having his crew install a fourth fake smokestack. Although it seemed like a shallow plan that would only be useful for a few minutes of distraction, that fleeting moment of hesitation would give Emden the advantage she needed to take down several enemy ships. The ocean's most dangerous vessel. Muller's plan worked. By early September of 1914, Emden had plundered 15 British trade ships in less than a week. His preferred attack maneuver consisted of approaching targets without flying flags. When getting close, the crew would fire a warning shot, hoist the German ensign, and advance. As the month neared its end, the British merchant fleet in India and Singapore was put to rest. With fewer targets in the Indian Ocean, Muller set his sights on shore targets such as oil depots. On September 22nd, Emden steamed into the port of Madras, India, and attacked the area's fuel depot with her 10 4-inch guns. After only 30 minutes, the Germans had unleashed a 125-round barrage that set the tanks ablaze. The fire also destroyed a nearby vessel in the harbor. The German ship sneaked out of Madras before shore batteries could attack her. During the days that followed, SMS Emden sank 6 more enemy ships. a sigh of relief. After early fall attacks, the British Royal Navy decided to cut down their presence in the Indian Ocean by 40%, slowing down the war supply chain movement. Low on supplies and ammunition, Muller then turned to the British port at Diego Garcia, an island in British Indian Ocean territory, to restock. Upon arrival, Emden's crew was surprised to realize that the British authorities in the area did not know that they were at war. Rather than turn their guns on the unsuspecting and vulnerable enemy, Muller took advantage of the situation and calmly reprovisioned, rested, repaired, and even repainted the ship. He even put a few of his men at work on a local resident's boat. After a few days, Emden returned to open water. The infamous Korvettenkapitän. While Emden wreaked havoc on the ocean, newspaper headlines from all over the world told her audacious stories. Tales of Korvettenkapitän Muller captured the globe, and he became known for ensuring the safety of the passengers in the enemy vessels he downed. According to eyewitnesses, Emden's crewmen were under strict orders to disembark all prisoners before scuttling a vessel. All the prisoners were then left back in neutral ports or transferred to non-belligerent ships. On one occasion, while posing as a British cruiser like she always did, Emden got close enough to the French Mousquet warship and unleashed a close-range attack. Muller then ordered the rescue of 35 survivors from the sinking ship and put them ashore. 5 crewmen died during the rescue mission and were buried by the crew with full military honors. Despite his gallantry, the British Royal Navy was less than enthralled with the German Korvettenkapitän. By October, over 60 Australian, Russian, French, and Japanese warships were summoned to spread across the southern seas to search and destroy the elusive German raider. Cocos Islands. Freshly resupplied and with a new coat of paint, Emden cruised over to British ports in Malaysia, attacking as many vessels as she could, including a Russian ship. By late October, Muller still refused to return to Germany and ordered his crew to head south. His latest idea involved maiming the telegraph wire that connected British troops in South Africa to those in Australia. The wire system had an essential junction at Direction Island in Cocos Islands. On the morning of November 9, 1914, Muller anchored the ship and ordered an armed landing party to take down the radio mast. After learning that they were witnessing yet another attack from the notorious Emden and her even more famous captain, the local population did not interfere. As a thank you gesture, Muller promised the locals to spare a popular park and tennis court near the tower. However, a quick-witted employee of the Eastern Telegraph Company managed to send a distress signal before the Germans captured the post. Emden's reign was about to end. A worthy adversary. HMAS Sydney, a Chatham-class light cruiser from the Royal Australian Navy, was nearby when the distress alarm was sent. The ship arrived on the scene in less than 3 hours. As Muller realized that an enemy ship was closing in, he ordered his men to abandon the crew that was still ashore and attack the Sydney, which was one quarter larger and heavily armed. In less than 2 hours, the German vessel had been hit over 100 times. The game was over for the ship that had been hindering British supply lines for months. Before noon, Muller steered Emden towards a nearby sandbar to avoid sinking. Still, Captain John Glossop, the commander of HMAS Sydney, continued to strike the hapless ship. By the end, the Australians had fired 670 rounds of ammunition upon the Germans, and the battle took the lives of almost half Emden's crew. By sunset, Muller ordered the survivors to haul down the German flag. He and the remaining crew were taken as prisoners. Watching the battle from ashore, the shocked 50-man party that stayed back eluded detention by commandeering an old vessel they found on the island. Once aboard, the crew made sail for Sumatra. HMAS Sydney's victory over SMS Emden during the Battle of Cocos was the Royal Australian Navy's first World War I victory. Emden. Although the Battle of Cocos was the end of SMS Emden, her story was far from over. As the war neared its end, Muller was released as a prisoner of war in Malta and returned to his homeland. Upon arrival in Germany, he was hailed as a hero and was promoted to captain. All of Emden's officers were awarded the Iron Cross First Class, and the remainder of the crew was awarded the Iron Cross Second Class, including the ship herself. Some of the loyal crewmen requested to change their last names to Emden, a singular distinction passed down to their descendants. Following the end of World War I, the German Navy has commissioned no less than 3 other Emden vessels, one of which remains in service today. Each of the namesake ships was painted with an Iron Cross on her hull to honor Muller's magnificent achievements. During her outstanding raiding career, which lasted just over 3 months and spanned 30,000 nautical miles, Emden destroyed 2 Entente warships and sank or captured 16 British steamers and 1 Russian merchant ship. 4 more British ships were caught and released, and 1 British and 1 Greek ship were subsequently used as colliers. After the Battle of Cocos, Emden's wreckage was plundered for war trophies before being broken up for scrap. 3 of the ship's guns are on display in Australia, and 1 still sits in Hyde Park in Sydney. Since the German vessel wreaked havoc in Indian waters over 100 years ago, her legacy has turned into something more significant. Today, the Tamil language has a peculiar word to describe someone who is sneaky, clever, or sly. Emden. Did you know the incredible story of SMS Emden? Please comment below if you have any other stories you want to see on our channels. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon to be notified of our latest videos.